Hi everyone, bonsoir, this is Sharik and welcome back to another lesson with Globetrot with Arabic. Today is day 15 in our 30-day challenge. I promised you I would be uploading one lesson every single day for a period of 30 days and I'm still going strong despite the challenges. So I hope you guys are challenging yourselves too and I hope you're studying really well and I hope you're also studying every single day. Before we begin our lesson today, let me ask you to subscribe to my channel if you're finding my lessons useful. Also follow me on Facebook and on Instagram because I also upload lessons there almost on a daily basis. Let's begin. Today I'm going to talk about two things. First of all, I'm going to say that it's my birthday. So when it's your birthday in Arabic, usually you just say happy birthday with the Arabic pronunciation, which goes happy birthday. Yeah, happy birthday. Or you say joyeux anniversaire, like the Lebanese way, with the French with a Lebanese accent. Joyeux anniversaire. But even if we use happy birthday or joyeux anniversaire, we also follow these with Arabic expressions. For example, if it's your birthday, I would tell you happy birthday, عقبال المية, عقبال المية. عقبال literally means in front of or opposite to. And then when you say المية, the 100, it's like you are wishing someone to see the 100 or to live until they are 100. So, عقبال المية. And it doesn't matter if you're talking to a guy, a girl, or many people. It's one fixed expression. You say, عقبال المية. Happy birthday, عقبال المية. But of course, you can also say happy birthday. You don't have to say happy birthday, okay? Or joyeux anniversaire, عقبال المية. Another expression would be, ينعاد عليك. ينعاد عليك. ينعاد may be repeated, عليك if it's a guy, and عليك if it's a girl. ينعاد عليك, ينعاد عليك. You can say both at the same time or the three of them at the same time. You can say happy birthday, عقبال المية, ينعاد عليك, and the long list of good wishes goes on and on. The second thing I'm going to talk about today are the documents that you might need when you apply for a visa, because tomorrow I'm going to the embassy of the Netherlands and I'm going to apply for a visa. And it's so annoying when you're Lebanese because you always have to apply for visas, you have to show them hundreds of documents. It's a bit annoying, but it's not that bad. So I will tell you what are the documents that I have just prepared to take with me tomorrow. So to begin with, let me tell you, tomorrow I have an appointment in the embassy of Netherlands. Bukra, tomorrow, عندي, I have, موعد means appointment. Bukra عندي موعد, بسفارة, in the embassy of, بسفارة, هولندا. Let me repeat this. Bukra عندي موعد, tomorrow I have an appointment, بسفارت, in the embassy of Hollanda. The word safara on its own means embassy and it finishes with a te marbuta, which we don't pronounce. Usually when the word is on its own we say safara, but when it's followed by another noun which makes it mean something of something else, then we pronounce the te marbuta. We say safarit Hollanda and we don't say safara Hollanda. And a tiny tip I can give you from now when it comes to Lebanese Arabic only is that when you start pronouncing the te marbuta, the fatha on the ra, for example, we say safara, becomes a kasra in this case, so it becomes safarit. And this applies to all the words that have a te marbuta. So let me repeat the sentence. Bukra عندي موعد بسفارة هولندا. Tomorrow I have an appointment in the embassy of the Netherlands. I want to also say that I will apply for a visa. So رح أقدم. أقدم means apply. رح أقدم means I will apply. رح أقدم على فيزا. Literally, I'm just saying I will apply on visa. رح أقدم على فيزا. Or I can also say رح أقدم طلب. I will present, basically I will present a request. رح أقدم طلب visa. I will present a visa request, which means I will apply basically for a visa. So رح أقدم طلب visa أو رح أقدم عفيزا. I can say عفيزا. Or if I want to call what the visa is, I would say رح أقدم عفيزة الشنغن. And you notice the word visa is not an Arabic word, but we took it and we Arabized it by adding the تاء مربوطة to it when I'm actually saying what kind of a visa is it. So instead of saying رح أقدم عفيزة شنغن, I'm saying رح أقدم عفيزة Schengen or Schengen, okay? Now, let me tell you what are the documents we need. So, first of all, we need my lovely Lebanese passport. So, هيدا جواز سفر. This is a passport. هيدا جواز سفر. If I want to say this is the passport, I would say هيدا جواز السفر. I'm adding the L, which means the at the beginning of سفر, but I'm pronouncing it جواز السفر because the word سفر starts with the سين and the letter سين is a sun letter, and all the words in Arabic that start with a س, the س sound, when we add L to them, which means the, we don't pronounce the L that is there. We just say سفر. So هيدا جواز السفر. This is the passport. I want to say this is a Lebanese passport. هيدا جواز سفر لبناني. هيدا جواز سفر لبناني. When I break جواز سفر down, it actually means a document of travel, which means a travel document, which means a passport. By the way, in Lebanese Arabic and in even other Arabic countries, we also say passport. We don't need to say جواز سفر. A lot of Arabic countries actually say passport. Some even pronounce it بسبور, for example, in Egypt. So it's a non-Arabic word that is almost considered as an Arabic word, the word passport. So I will need a passport. That's what I'm gonna say. So رح كون بحاجة ل, رح كون, I will be بحاجة, in need of or for, رح كون بحاجة ل, which means for, ل passport, my passport. So رح كون بحاجة ل passport, I will be in need of my passport, which means I will need my passport. So رح كون بحاجة لباسبوري ورح كون بحاجة لصورة عن الباسبور. صورة عن الباسبور means a picture, literally a photo or a picture. صورة عن, which literally means about, but we don't mean about here. So صورة عن الباسبور, a picture about the passport, which means the picture of the passport. So رح كون بحاجة للباسبور. That's number one. رح كون بحاجة لصورة عن الباسبور, a photo of the passport, صورة عن الباسبور. That's the first thing. رح كون بحاجة لصورتين, two photos, صورة, صورتين. Okay? The photo of the passport, the passport photo, we call it صورة شمسية. سورة شمسية. That's a photo passport. This is just a سورة, a photo, a normal photo. This is سورة شمسية. And in Arabic also, when you want to say a copy of something, as you noticed, I also said سورة, سورة عن الباسبور. So a copy of something, سورة شمسية. In this case, سورتين, because I need two photos, سورتين. I will need my passport. رح كون بحاجة لباسبوري. رح كون بحاجة لسورتين or سورة شمسية. ورح كون بحاجة لسورة عن الباسبور, a copy of my passport. And now I will say رح كون بحاجة للإقامة, the immigration card, الإقامة. Or I can say إقامتي. إقامة in Arabic literally means residing or living in a place. That's why when I say إقامة, again, it's my actual card that allows me to live in the UK. So رح كون بحاجة للإقامة والباسبور. Let me also check what else I need. ورح كون بحاجة كمان لصور. So that's the plural of سورة, which means a copy. So رح كون بحاجة لصور, the plural of سورة. صور الفيز يلي أخدتن من قبل. So again, رح كون بحاجة ل, I will need لصور of photos, لفيز of visas أخذتن من قبل. I took them, which means I received them or I've been given them من قبل. So أخذت means I took. أخذتن means I took them. Min qabl literally means from before. That's how you say before in Arabic. From before. Min qabl. So, رح كون بحاجة لا, I will need صور عن الفيز. صور عن الفيز يلي أخذتن قبل. Which I took them before. That's how we say it in Arabic. رح كون كمان بحاجة لورقة عمل. Again, رح كون كمان بحاجة لورقة عمل. ورقة means a paper, literally, but it also means a document. ورقة عمل, a document of work. Again, the word ورقة on its own has a T مربوطة, which we don't pronounce. But when I follow it by the word عمل, which makes it noun plus noun, I then pronounce ورقة عمل. You notice the word ورقة on its own has a A. But when I add the عمل to it, it's becoming ورقة عمل. ورقة عمل. So there's a كسرة in that case. So ورقة عمل is an employment letter, basically. Usually in Lebanon, we don't use the word عمل for work. We use more the word شغل, okay? Because عمل is more standard Arabic. But when it comes to this document, I don't usually say ورقة شغل, which would be okay to say. We usually stick to the official term, which is ورقة عمل. So, رح كون بحاجة لورقة عمل. ورح كون كمان بحاجة, which is here in my hand, لورقة المعاش. معاش means salary. Salary. ورقة المعاش means the paper of the salary of or the document of the salary, which means your payslip. Okay. So رح كون بحاجة كمان لورقة المعاش. I will also need the payslip. ورقة المعاش. Now, I will also need to show them that I booked the hotel. So, رح كمان كون بحاجة ل ورقة حجز. حجز means booking. ورقة, as we said, the document. ورقة حجز للأوتيل, for the hotel. ورقة حجز للأوتيل. كمان رح كون بحاجة ل, I will need ل تيكت الطيارة. Ticket at-tiyara. So we usually say for the plane. We don't say for the flight in Arabic. So for example, if I'm traveling tomorrow, I say عندي tiyara bukra. I have a plane tomorrow, which means I have a flight tomorrow. So I want to also tell you, I have to show them. لازم فرجيون. فرجي in Arabic means to show. But when I add the on means show to them, I have to say فرجيون. I'm not going to pronounce it فرجيون anymore. I pronounce it فرجيون. Okay? So, لازم, literally it means must. In this case, I mean I must. لازم فرجيون. I have to show them. ورقة حجز, a book, a paper of booking من الأوتيل, from the hotel. وحجز ticket الطيارة. Just ticket الطيارة. I will also need a bank statement. A bank statement in Arabic is كشف حساب. كشف حساب. حساب means account. And كشف literally in Arabic means revealing or declaring. That's why it means bank statement. In English you would say bank statement. In Arabic you would say a revealing of an account, which means كشف حساب, which means a bank statement. So كمان لازم فرجيون. I also have to show them. كمان لازم فرجيون كشف حساب, a bank statement. So I have to show them, of course, the application form. I would say ورقة الطلب, literally the document of the request, which means application. Or we would say application in Lebanon, okay? So ورقة الطلب, I will say لازم عبي, I have to fill. لازم عبي, to fill, ورقة الطلب. So لازم عبي ورقة الطلب, I have to fill in the application form. وكمان لازم فرجيون, I also have to show them ورقة من الأسيرانس, ورقة أسيرانس. Okay, let me repeat this. كمان لازم فرجيون ورقة assurance, or I can say ورقة تأمين. تأمين means insurance, and we also use a lot the word assurance, a French word pronounced in the Lebanese way, assurance, which is insurance. So لازم فرجيون ورقة assurance, or lazim farjiun war it ta'min. If I want to be specific, of course I can say war it ta'min safar, which means travel insurance. War'a, document, ta'min insurance, safar, traveling, war it ta'min safar, travel insurance, which means a document for insuring traveling. Okay? Do I need anything else? Let me check. So, let me repeat the whole list. Firstly, I will need the application form. So I said لازم أعبي ورقة الطلب. I have to fill in the application form. لازم أعبي ورقة الطلب. The, if I want to say the application form, I would say ورقة الطلب. I would write it ورقة الطلب, but I would pronounce it ورقة الطلب. So لازم أعبي ورقة الطلب. لازم يكون معي صورة شمسية. I'm checking the documents because it's a long list. لازم يكون معي صورة شمسية. Actually لازم يكون معي, I should have on me, لازم يكون معي صورتين. Okay. وكمان لازم يكون معي أكيد, of course, جواز السفر أو الباسبور. لازم يكون معي صورة عن الباسبور, a photo of the passport, a copy of the passport basically. لازم يكون معي, I must have on me, لازم يكون معي صور للفيز, of the visas. I can also say لقدام, the old, the old. القدام pronounced as لقدام with a liaison. لازم يكون معي, I should have on me, صور للفيز لقدام, photos of the old visas. لازم يكون معي ورقة تأمين. ورقة تأمين is the travel insurance. If I want to say ورقة تأمين سفر, literally I'm saying the document of insuring traveling. ولازم يكون عندي كمان شو اسمه, ورقة الحجز, ورقة حجز للأوتيل, document of booking of the hotel. وكمان لازم يكون معي ticket الطيارة, which means the ticket of the plane. I didn't say this. لازم يكون عندي تذكرة سفر. تذكرة سفر. تذكرة is a ticket of traveling. Okay, so لازم يكون معي تذكرة سفر, which means my flight ticket. Okay, ticket الطيارة أو حجز للطيارة أو تذكرة سفر. Of course, this is something I should have mentioned before. تذكرة سفر. كشف حساب, bank statement. And finally, they are also asking for a cover letter explaining why I'm gonna go. So let me say this. لازم اكتب. لازم اكتب. I need to write. لازم اكتب. I will say مكتوب, because in Lebanese Arabic we use مكتوب, a letter, more than رسالة. رسالة means a letter, but مكتوب means also a letter. In Lebanon we use this more. مكتوب also literally means written, that paper that's written. That's why it's called مكتوب, because a letter is something that you write. Okay, so لازم اكتب مكتوب or لازم اكتب رسالة للسفارة, to the embassy. And I want to say I have to explain to them why I'm traveling. لازم فسر لون. لازم فسر. فسر, I explain. لازم فسر لون. I have to explain to them. ليه رح سافر أو ليش رح سافر. ليش means why. رح means will. سافر means travel. ليش رح سافر. Let me repeat this one more time. لازم فسر لون. ليش رح سافر. I have to explain to them why I'm gonna travel. And finally, the fees are 60 euros. لازم ادفع. I have to pay. لازم ادفع 60 euro. 60 euro. Or I can also say الرسم, which means the fee. الرسم أو رسم الفيزا. رسم الفيزا. The fee of the visa. رسم الفيزا 60 euro. Yes, it's 60 euros. وباخد الفيزا عادة, and I usually take the visa. باخد, I take الفيزا, the visa, عادة, usually, بس لثلاث أشهر. Only for 3 months. بس لثلاث أشهر. I think that's it for today. Yes, the long list has ended finally. I hope it was useful, and I will see you tomorrow in another lesson. Bye!